In this method, in this segment, we're going to take an example of how to use finite difference methods to solve ordinary differential equations. So we're going to take a simple pragmatic example here. I suppose somebody says that, hey, I have a simply supported beam, and what I want to be able to do is that I'm applying some tension T to it, let's suppose. And then I'm also applying some uniformly distributed load to it, let's suppose Q. I suppose the length of the beam is L. Then the differential equation which governs how much this particular beam is deflecting is given by d2y by dx square minus t of ty divided by ei is equal to qx times l minus x divided by 2ei. That's the differential equation which governs this particular problem here. And y is the deflection. So y is the deflection, which is measured like this. So this is y here is the deflection, and x is the location at a particular point along the beam. So let me just go and put some values of these variables in there. So let's suppose T is, somebody gives me it, that the amount of tension which they're applying is 7,200 pounds. The constant load which they're applying, the uniform load which they're applying, not constant load, but the uniform load which they're applying is 5,400 pounds per inch. The length of the specimen is given as 75 inches. The Young's modulus, E is the Young's modulus. So E, which you're seeing here, is the Young's modulus, is given as 30 MSI, which is 30 times 10 to the power 6 PSI. And let's suppose I, which is the second moment of area, please don't call it moment of inertia. Second moment of area is 120 inch raised power 4. So if somebody told me to go ahead and use finite difference methods to solve this particular problem, I would say, hey, what I'll have to do is I'll have to take this length L of the beam and break it up into small segments. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this length of the beam, which is right here, and I'm going to, this is 75 inches, which I know, which is the length which is given to me. So I'm going to call this to be node 1, let's suppose, call this to be node 2, call this to be node 3, and call this to be node 4. So what I'm doing is, the problem statement is telling me that, hey, go ahead and choose three segments for doing the finite difference approximation. So in that case, what will happen is that this delta x, which I have, which is the distance between the two nodes, is going to be 75 divided by 3 is going to be 25 inches. That's what delta x is going to turn out to be. So that means that if I'm able to, I already know that the value of the deflection at node 1 is 0. I already know the deflection at node 4 is 0 because it's simply supported at those two particular nodes. So if I need to find out what the value of the deflection is at node 2 and node 3. So how am I going to do that? I'm going to first substitute the values of the constants which I had just found out, and I'll get d2y by dx square minus 2 times 10 to the power minus 6y is equal to 7.5 times 10 to the power minus 7x times 75 minus x. This particular equation I get by substituting the values of the tension T, the uniformly distributed load Q, the length L, E, and I. That's what I get as my equation. So I now need to be able to set up this finite difference equations for this. So I'm going to, what I'm going to do is I'm going to approximate my second derivative at some node I by my central divided difference approximation of that, and that's what it will turn out to be. This is the central divided approximation of the second derivative of y with respect to x at any node I. What that means is that if I'm at node I, there'll be a node I minus 1 to the left and node I plus 1 to the left, and that will give me the approximation of the second derivative of y with respect to x. So if I do that, then I know that going back to the nodes which I have, that, hey, I have node 1 here, then I have node 2 here, node 3 here, and node 4 here. And I start with x equal to 0 here. This will be x equal to 25 because delta x is 25. This will be x equal to 50, and this will be x equal to 75. So when I write down this, when I substitute the second derivative approximation in my formula, this is what I'm going to get. I'm going to get y sub I plus 1 minus 2 y sub I plus y sub I minus 1 divided by delta x squared. That is the approximation for the second derivative. Minus 2 times 10 to the power minus 6, and that will be the value of y at that particular node, because now I'm rewriting my ordinary differential equation for that particular node. And that will be equal to 7.5 times 10 to the power minus 6 times the value of x at that particular node times 75 minus the value of x at that particular node, x of I, by dear.